Hello guys, and welcome to this tutorial video from biology slideshow. In this video we will talk about gel zymography technique. This technique is based on SDS page, which is a traditional method for protein separation. So in this video I will not go in details of SDS page and protein separation basics. So I highly recommend you to watch the SDS page video before, which I will provide its link in the description below, and then you can follow and understand the differences that I will explain between the original SDS page and gel zymography technique. So gel zymography is electrophoretic technique, is a technique depends on the electrophoresis to detect the hydrolytic enzymes. In this case, we should maintain the proteins in their active form, so we don't use any reducing agent because we want to detect the activity of the hydrolytic enzymes. So in those slides, I will explain the major differences between SDS page and gel zymography. The SDS page case will be on the right of slides, and gel zymography will be on the left side. Gel casting is the first step of protein electrophoresis technique. In case of SDS page, we prepare polyacrylamide gel in two different concentration, in two different pH buffers for resolving and stacking gel. And the same for zymography gel, but we add the substrate of the enzyme of interest to the resolving gel. And this might be added to the water that used in the resolving gel formula. So the casein or gelatin, for example, will be evenly distributed through the resolving gel. The next step is loading the proteins and running the gel. After that, the proteins will be separated based on their molecular weight. So the smallest molecular weight proteins is the fastest to move through the polyacrylamide gel in both cases. In case of zymography gel, the gel after running is called zymogram. After that, we do the washing step. In case of SDS page, no need for extensive washing step, no need for activation step. We just to stain the gel. But in case of gel zymography, we need to remove the remaining SDS, which allow to reform the proteins and to restore the enzymatic activity of the protein of interest. After that, they will be incubated. This is known as activation, and the activation buffer contains the required molecules that activate the protein of interest. In case of MMB, which is gelatinase, we use calcium chloride and zinc chloride. After that, we do stain the gel. We use Comasi Brilliant Blue, the most common dye to stain the gels. After that, the gels in both cases of SDS page and zymography gel will be stained in a blue. The next step is destaining. So when we destain the gel, we remove the excess amount of dye out of the gel. So in case of SDS page, only the proteins bound to the dye molecules and will be stained on blue on a transparent background. The opposite is zymography, because the gelatin is evenly distributed in the resolving gel, and only the portion where the catalytic enzyme exists and activated, there will be a degradation represented as transparent band on a blue background. So those are two gel photos. In case of SDS page, blue bands on transparent background, and the opposite in the case of gel zymography. The catalytic enzymes will appear in transparent bands on the blue background. So that was everything. Thank you for watching.